Hey, it's Doug Lee here again. In the previous video, we discussed the method for quick reading and quick learning. In this video, I will show you a method for deep reading. This method is developed by professors as a textbook reading strategy. This method can help the reader to remember more of what they read. The method is originally called SQ3R. Later, more R's are added, so sometimes it becomes SQ4R or even SQ5R. But here, to keep things simple, I will stick with SQ3R. SQ3R is an acronym for 5 steps to effectively read and learn. S stands for survey. Q stands for question. The 3 R's are read, recite, and review. The first step for deep reading is survey. We want to obtain a general idea of what we are reading through a quick survey. We want to know how the information is organized and what we need to learn. The items we want to survey usually include the table of content, headings, subheadings, preface, summary, or conclusions. We may also want to check out major graphs or images. The survey will allow us to obtain a general idea on what the main ideas are and how the chapters are organized. This will help us visualize and make sense of the text when we read through it later. Survey is more like reading a picture rather than reading text from beginning to end. When we read a picture, we usually do not read from top to bottom or from left to right. We want to read the whole picture first and then decide where to read for more details. When we are writing, we are actually converting a picture of ideas in our mind into the linear output of text. Therefore, when we are reading, we do not want to be limited by the linear form of text. We want to try our best to restore the big picture in the mind of the authors. And that is the purpose of survey before actual reading. The second step is question. While doing the survey, it is very natural we want to start ask questions based on what we already know on the topics we are reading. This will help us to establish association between the new information and our existing knowledge. And it makes the new information easier to remember. One method is to turn each heading and subheading into a question. The question will make our reading become a process of looking for answers. And therefore, the reading will become more motivated and focused. When we intend and try hard to look for answers for a question, when we find it, it is more likely we'll be able to remember it. It may be helpful to write down the questions to refer to as we start reading. After survey and question, we may begin to read the information one section at a time. The reading is just 1 R in the SQ3R method, but the reading process actually involves more R's, such as respond, reduce, and record. Respond means we should always keep our questions in mind, and we actively look for answers to respond to these questions. Reduce means we should try our best to reduce the new information to some brief keywords or key concepts that make more sense to us based on our existing knowledge. Record means taking notes on the key ideas obtained from reading. Respond, reduce, and record are the three R's we need when we conduct deep reading. All these three R's can help us to associate the new information with our existing knowledge, and therefore can help us to better understand. Respond involves answering questions that fill gaps in our existing knowledge. Reduce involves digesting new information and connecting them to old information and summarizing all the information. Record is taking notes using our own words. Record not only can help us to understand now, but also can help us for review in the future. While reading, we should focus on looking for new concepts rather than new facts. Facts are fragment information that can easily be forgotten. We don't really need to remember many facts, since we can always use Google when we need them. When facts are connected with each other, they may form new concepts. Concepts are usually a condensed form of knowledge that provides relationships among facts. Many courses in college may spend a whole semester just to explain a few key concepts. Focusing on concepts is a typical shortcut to grasp new knowledge. The good news is it is natural for human brain to remember relationships much easier than single facts. Facts can easily be forgotten, but for concepts, once we grasp it, it will usually stay with us for a lifetime. When we conduct deep reading, the ability to identify key concepts, the ability to reduce the new information to form new concepts, and the ability to reduce all the fragment facts and highlight the logic behind them determines the effectiveness of our learning. After the reading, we want to take chance to recite and review what we have read. These two R's help us to retain the information we learned. By recite, we internalize the information we learned. By review, we reinforce the information we learned into long-term memory that can be used in the future. For recite, we may explain to others what we have learned in simple, reduced forms. We may also answer the questions we have without opening the book. Recite is a necessary step to confirm that we really understand what we have read. The quality of recite reflects the quality of our learning. If we are not able to recite clearly and concisely, that almost always indicates that we do not really understand, and we failed to connect the new information with our existing knowledge. For review, we may consult our record. And sometimes we may want to go back and reread some sections selectively based on our updated knowledge at the time of review. The world is connected, so is the knowledge. When we have read enough books, we may be more sensitive on relationships among books. Comparing how the same problems are viewed by different authors is also an effective way to improve our understanding on what we are reading. Sometimes we may even witness the evolution of human knowledge in the history. Thanks for watching. I'm Doug Liu with Research Tips for the Underdogs. Deep reading is usually for grasping new concepts, and skimming is usually for expanding existing concepts. SQ3R is an effective deep reading method that can help us to learn more and remember longer. Until next time, let's keep it as a natural way when it is time for some deep reading.